Ben Osmanlı Torun. Yes, this is Tura. Yes.
Yes, Tura.
I feel that. I feel this in my soul. I feel like Bosniaks first, but after that, like Ottoman.
Fala kalemdar Abdullah Mehmeti.
First 99.
Yes, but it's so romantic. I don't like. Here, everyone knows everything. You can talk about anything you want. Religion, politician.
Yeah, like Turkey. Everybody has some idea about everything. You can talk about Elon Musk. Next second, you can talk about Erdogan. And then you can talk about like Hindu gods. You know? Then. Pazarın ikinci sabahından herkese günaydın. Şöyle başlıyorum güne. Buna mantı diyorlar burada. Yeni Pazar bayağı meşhur mantısıyla. İçinde kıyma var. Bu da yoğurt. Bildiğiniz yoğurt. İçilen yoğurt. Her zaman gösterdiğim burada. Böyle bir porsiyonda 10 parça var. Ve 250 dinar. Yani 15 lira falan ediyor. Dualar. Şimdi kalktım. Burası da meydanın tam ortası. Yani hala Sırbistan'da bir şehirdeyiz. Ve meydanın ortasında bu tarz oryantal bir yapı var. Şimdi Türkiye Cumhuriyeti Konsolosluğu'na gidiyorum. Evet, Yeni Pazar'da bir Türkiye Cumhuriyeti Konsolosluğu var. Ve yeni açılmış. Asıl gitme amacım Kosova ile ilgili bilgi edinmek. Çünkü PCR testi istiyor mu istemiyor mu emin değilim. Ve birkaç güne buradan ayrılacağım. Sınır geçişi nasıl olacak? Ve PCR testi isteniyor mu şu anda bizden? Bunları öğrenmek istiyorum. Zaten hani mümkün değilse buradan sınır geçmem veya PCR testi falan isteniyorsa direkt Karadağ'a geçmeyi düşünüyorum. Ya bu da güzel oldu aslında, yani böyle bir yerde bizim konsolosluğumuzun olması. Şimdi burada tam 300 yıldan fazladır ailesiyle birlikte yaşayan harika bir arkadaşla birlikteyiz. O size burayı o kadar güzel anlatacak ki şimdi, bana az önce anlattı. Böyle başından geçenleri, yaşadıklarını, ailesiyle ilgili her şeyi, yani çok güzel anlattı. Ben siz de duyun istiyorum.
Ben anladım.
Anladın mı?
Evet, anladım. Benim adım Hamza.
Türkçe biliyorsun.
Biraz.
Biraz.
Biraz Türkçe biliyorum.
Bu kadar mı? Daha var mı?
Var var.
Türkiye'ye geldin mi?
Sadece bir ilki time.
İlk
just one time. Yes.
One time. One time.
One time.
tek sefer.
So you were born and raised here, right?
Yes. My father, my grandfather, my more than 300 years. Yes. For me, it's so old in this city. You can feel, and people, for example, you can be hungry here. Mm-hmm. Can everyone, if you want something for help, everyone will help you.
Burada çok kısaca araya giriyorum. Eğer videoyu beğenirseniz lütfen beğene tıklamayı unutmayın. Aynı zamanda kanalıma abone olarak yolculuğuma en iyi desteği vermiş olursunuz. Yanındaki zil işaretini de açarak paylaşımlarımdan anlık olarak haberdar olabilirsiniz. Ve öneri ve görüşlerinizi, aynı zamanda iyi veya kötü bütün eleştirilerinizi de yorumlar kısmında bekliyorum.
And we don't look, are you Muslim, are you Serb? We don't look that. If you are in trouble, we help you. It's in our blood, it's our tradition. Especially for me, I have some connect with Ottomans because I read. I'm still reading for my family, mm-hmm. And I'm still in search from my family in past. And I think I have some connected with Ottomans.
Mm-hmm.
Ben Osmanlı torun. Yes, this is Torah. Yes. For example, when I was in Kuwait in Saudi Arabia, that people said me that I'm Turkish.
I wouldn't be surprised. But actually, you are Bosnian.
Yes, Bosnian. We are Bosniak here.
We are Bosnian. So, can you clarify what's the difference between Bosniak and Bosnians? Because people are a bit actually confused with these kind of terms.
Yes, yes. We were one with the nationality and people in Bosnia. But after annexion of Bosnia, we're cut it. And we stay here with Serb, between Serbs and Montenegrins. But we, even now, we're feeling like the same one with the people in Bosnia.
Yeah.
And the Bosniaks is nationality. Bosnian, it's from country. We don't call us Serbian. We don't hate anyone, but we are Bosniaks.
So 85% of the people in Novi Pazar, I heard,
yes,
Bosniaks, right?
Bosniak, yes.
What's the worst thing that you would say about Novi Pazar?
It's a very good question. The worst thing here is some philosophy called Tafra. Tafra.
Tafra.
Yes.
Tafra. Okay.
Tafra.
You have the same word in Turkish.
Some word.
But I want to listen if it's the same.
Yes. I heard this word, for example, in Saudi Arabia. It's Arabic word. Tafra. It means you show to people what is not inside of you. Just for them. Okay. Buy some cars, some telephones.
Off.
Yes.
Shopping off.
But you're poor inside.
Yes.
It's not you.
Yeah.
For example, in nightlife here, you see so many young people, so many cars. We're looking at each other, what you have buy, what you your cars. This is worst things. I really don't like
you
that.
Don't.
It's not our tradition. It's not from citizens from Novi Pazar. Mm-hmm. It's from guests.
So you actually consider yourself a son of Ottoman Empire?
Yes, I'm proud of that.
Yes.
I'm proud. I feel like Bosniaks first, but after that, like Ottomans. Because Ottoman Empire was here 500 years. It's not little.
Mm-hmm.
And you... Even now you can see the buildings, you can hear the stories about them. And even now we hear the Turkish music, Turkish songs, even we don't understand.
TV series,
yes,
also.
Yes, TV series, yes.
No, Kurtlar Vadisi.
Kurtlar Vadisi, Kai, yes, the Kurtlar Vadisi, my brother, like that, so.
Yeah.
Polat Alemdar, Abdulay, Mehmati.
First 99 series.
Yes, but it's so romantic, I don't like.
Geleneksel bir mantıcı burası ve Novi Pazar'ın en iyisi. Tam Arap Cami'nin karşısında.
As we for Istanbul, this was called Istanbul Cadde. Even now, old people call here Istanbul Cadde.
Bakın ya, siz buraya İstanbul Caddesi diyorlarmış.
Traditional food from Novi Pazar, from Bosniaks. Traditional family here.
One of the best shops.
Yeah.
This is the best place you can taste
it.
Yes.
Ah, okay.
Traditional you.
Everything is traditional.
Yes, traditional.
Traditional pillows.
Yes.
Ispanaklı. Spinach.
This is not a pie, this is called zelanik.
Zelanik.
Yes.
Şimdi burada pita dedikleri olay buymuş. Ispanaklı falan böyle içinde. Bizim bildiğimiz börek gibi yani aslında ama burada pita diyorlar. Bu da bayağı bildiğiniz yoğurt ama burada mineralli süt diyorlarmış. Yani enteresan bir şekilde, değil mi? Like, so this is how we eat yogurt.
Yes.
But actually you drink yogurt.
We drink yogurt, yes.
And it's complicated.
Yes.
Balkans is complicated.
I think it's from Suleyman Kanuni. He said the Balkan is a place with blood and honey. We have here so many beauty things, very beautiful. But with that beauty, you have wars, you have blood, you have terrible things.
Both at the same time.
Yes.
Afiyet olsun.
Afiyet olsun. Sana da afiyet olsun.
So this is mante, 10 of them. How much is it?
Money?
Yes.
200.
So you are the owner of the place, right?
Yes. Yes.
What's your name?
My name is Yasmi. My father was a bus.
Uh-huh.
My father was a boxer. But I baker.
Şimdi yukarı çıkıyoruz. Fırına bakacağız.
Merhaba.
Merhaba.
They making mante.
this best food in Serbia, in Novi Pazar.
Novi Pazar.
Traditional food in Novi Pazar.
İşte bu gördüğünüz şekilde mantıları yapıyorlar burada.
These are all for mantia or?
Yes, all for mantia. Thousand mantia on day.
Uh-huh.
On week 20,000 mantia on week.
Fabrika gibi mantı basıyorlar burada. Aynen. Mantı fabrikası ya. This is your factory.
Yes. Half factory. This another factory.
Yeah, you have another one.
Making pita.
Pita.
Yes, pita.
Yes.
Yes.
You have a wife. You have
no,
wife.
I don't have a wife. I'm
evli miyim, bekar mıyım diye sordular da bekarım dedim, hepsi gidiyor. How long have you been running
20,
this?
20 years. President Erdogan, President son Bilal and many, many.
Erdogan and Bilal came
yes,
here.
Yes, they came here together.
Did they like?
They, yes, mantı? Of course. They asking us to opening mantıya factory in
Turkey.
Istanbul.
Istanbul.
In Turkey, yes.
Will you do that?
The,
maybe.
Maybe Erdogan famous with potato.
Pot-
with ice cream.
With ice cream?
Yes.
Allah
imanet. Allah
imanet. Ciao.
Burada yaşlı boşnak dayılar var. Bütün gün burada takılıyor bunlar. Türk lokumu.
Türk.
Türk lokumu. Buralar, bu çatıları falan görüyorsunuz. You call kiremit also, right? Kiremit.
Ha, kiremit. Kiremit. Yes.
Kiremit. Kiremit. Kiremitler falan buralar pencere. Hep böyle Osmanlılardan kalma. Pencere.
Yes, pencere.
Tencere.
I'm so proud because my people, when I said my people, I mean people from Sanjak, Bosniaks. We are gave so many shahids and warriors from this place, from Sanjak. More than 10,000 people came shahids in Çanakkale. It was the most important battle in Turkish history because it was not just for Turkish people, battle for Islam, for every Muslims in the world. Because Istanbul, everyone knows that it's the most important city in world.
Mm-hmm. And we are also wondering what Sanjak is, and also people still call this place, especially the region, Sanjak.
Sanjak, yes.
So maybe you can explain a little bit deeper.
We still proud with that name, Sanjak, and wherever we go in world, we tell for people we are from Sanjak. They ask us what is the Sanjak, and then we explain Sanjak was a part from Ottoman Empire. We are now in Serbia, but we still with the name Sanjak. We have a bayrak, we have a flag.
Mm-hmm.
And it's
Novi Pazar is its own flag, right?
Yes, its own flag. Sanjak is own flag.
We are still like the surviving parts of the Ottoman Empire.
Just 100 years the Ottoman Empire was here. It's not so many years, and we feel, until now we feel that we like when someone from Turkey come here, we feel like we are just one.
I feel like this city, Novi Pazar, is a bit neglected, and not many people in Turkey knows the place. That's why actually I wanted to visit, and I wanted to show the people there is this side of this country as well. I'm still in Serbia, but like
yes,
this is the interesting part, because I came from Niš, and after that I went to Belgrade and then Novi Sad was my favorite after all, but after I came here, this has like this city has real spirit, you know. Novi Sad has a spirit for its own,
yes, for its own,
but
yes.
Novi Pazar, actually we call it Yeni
pazar.
Yeni pazar.
Has its own like characteristic and has its own soul, has its own spirit.
We still have a soul from Orient. You can feel the Europe and the East in the one city.
Yes, that's right. So what do you do here? What do you do for life?
I am a teacher of Arabic language here. We have here so many young people, they learn the Turkish language. You can see even with language, we are connected, as you said before. We have a TV series now, too many TV series they watched in all Serbia.
I think in all Serbia, yeah, the Serbian children
also
learning some Turkish from the
Maybe TV it's
series.
More than we are here. The history has their own story. But life is something another. And even now, you will find Serbs who respect the Ottomans, who respect Turkey. They want to connect it. Even now, Turkey opened the companies here, fabrics for people, for Serbs. Life is something another. History and books is something another. And can live in peace if we have a tolerance, if we talk to each other. And
Thank you so much, Hamza. Really nice to meet you, and all this valuable information will be really helpful for me and for the people who are
I'm
watching
so glad
us
that
also.
I meet you, especially because you are from Turkey, and just I feel like we are brothers. And nice to meet you.
So Armin, where are we heading now?
We are heading to the old bazaar that was the place of the city before Yeni Pazar, before İsabey İsakovic.
So before Yeni Pazar was invented by İsabey.
It was, the main point was here.
The trading route.
Yes.
Was here.
Yes. And there's also one more important place, it's called Monastery of Sopçani. For me it is also one of the most beautiful monasteries because of the frescoes, paintings inside. Mm-hmm. Colors are still alive.
It would be interesting to see that.
It is interesting. Peter's Church, they always ask you to pay for the entrance because foreigners pay, and here as well. But I smuggle people every time.
So. I say zdravo.
Yeah, just say zdravo.
What was the name of the place again?
The Monastery of Sopçani.
Yes.
It is. The monastery is always a complex. The church and the surrounding, and that's a symbol not just of religion but also of power. And we'll see that inside.
Oh, small group now. Yeah. Hello again.
Hello.
How about your names?
Amina, Ayşe, Ceyman.
How many of you know some Turkish and been to Turkey?
Ben, yeah, biraz. We all have been to Turkey.
Yeah.
She's studying in Turkey. I'm studying in Turkey.
Yeah. Turkey is like our
second. Merhaba arkadaşlar.
Evet. Merhaba herkese. Abone ol.
Abone ol.
Like atmayı unutmayın.
Unutmayın. Haydi.
Haydi.
Yağmur yağacak. Büyük ihtimalle birazdan.
So this is the main gate. Serbia was never eastern or western state. It was always and will always be somewhere in between. If you see it like this, it looks like a Catholic church, but this is an Orthodox church. So exterior of the but the interior is totally Byzantine Eastern Orthodox style. So that's why it's protected by UNESCO. This here fresco is one of the most beautiful and most important frescoes in the whole world. So it is also extremely large, and it depicts the Holy Mary, the death of Holy Mary. But just pay attention to the faces. You have to understand this. At this time there was no Instagram, there were no pictures. Renaissance was after this.
Yes.
And look at the faces, look at the bodies, look at their clothes. That's something that you don't see at that time, because the art was not so profound at that time. So that's why this fresco is a pure form of art. This is Renaissance before Renaissance. Look at the faces, and you see these apostles, these are friends of Jesus and friends of Mary. Look at the faces and how they express grief. You see, the color is like Mona Lisa, and we call it Mona Lisa from Sopcani. Wherever you move, it looks
this
at
one.
You. Yeah, it looks
Let's
at
move.
You. Yeah, you can see that. And just look at the clothes.
Mona Lisa gibi. You said which century was that?
13th century.
13th century.
800 years.
Yes.
Ago. Let's go. Literate people thought that if they have the fragments from the frescoes and they eat it or put it on their wand, that it will heal. It has magical powers. So you will see in many churches the eyes and faces cropped because of that.
Blue color.
And it's made of lapis lazuli. Lapis lazuli is a mineral which was taken from Afghanistan, only in Afghanistan, so 800 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
If you had lapis lazuli and blue color like that, that meant that you are really rich. So 1 kilo of lapis lazuli and blue color like that means 1 kilo of gold. And you saw how much of blue was there.
Şimdi çok fena yağmur başladı. Manastırdan hemen sonra şöyle bir yere geldik. Burası bayağı popüler bir restoranmış. Pazariş diye bir yer. Bölgenin ismi de Pazariş zaten. Buradan böyle akıyor gidiyor işte. You all taking Turkish classes in the school?
Yes. Years of Turkish classes.
2 years.
Yeah.
You have to take it or?
Yeah, we have to choose from Turkish or French, and uh-huh. We chose Turkish because we love Turkey and we love Turkish.
And it's easier.
Yeah, and it's
easier. Yeah, you already have some words anyway.
Yeah, yeah.
You said two letters is confusing you.
Benim için iki tane en zor harf var Türkçe'de. Birisi O, O şey var ya, çift noktalı. Diğerisi de
I have it in my surname.
Evet, evet.
Benim,
nasıl?
Benim soy ismimde var. Ö ve Ü.
Öztürk.
Öztürk.
Öztürk.
Ö, Ü. Ö and Ü.
Öztürk.
Öztürk, yes. Like Öztürk. Yes.
Kolay değil.
Hiç kolay değil bu işten. Burası aynı zamanda UNESCO tarafından korunan bir yer. Korunsun zaten ya. Böyle yerleri korusunlar ya. Koruma hep ne yapacaklar? Baksanıza. Pet şişeler mi olsun yani şuralarda? Yine yağmurlu bir gün. Bitmedi şu yağmurlar. Harbiden bitmedi. Ben bittim. Yağmur bitmedi ya. Şöyle de bir güzelliği var yağmurun. Yağmur yağınca alerjim tutmuyor. Yağmura çok da şikayetçi olamıyorum açıkçası. Şimdi dönüşe geçiyoruz. Nice to meet you again.
Memnun oldum.
Memnun oldum. Ben de memnun oldum.
Çok memnun oldum.
Bugün yeni pazarda son günüm. Yarın artık Karadağ'a geçmeyi planlıyorum. Hatta yani şu güne kadar Karadağ mı Kosova mı belli değildi nereye gideceğim. Ama sonunda karar verdim Karadağ. En büyük rolü de PCR testi istememesi oynadı. Aynı zamanda Karadağ'la ilgili şöyle bir şey öğrendim. Devlet hastanelerinde PCR testi bedavaymış. Ve nasıl olacak? Böylece Kosova'ya ve Bosna'ya da oradan ücretsiz bir şekilde geçebilecek. Nefes nefese kaldım. Yukarı çıkacağım çünkü bayağı buradan. Evin yerini biliyorsunuz. Doğayla iç içe bir yerde. Bayağı böyle dağın tepesinde. O yüzden biraz yürüyeceğim. Gördünüz mü az önce amcanın ne yaptığını? Belki 70 yaşının üzerinde ki öyle görünüyor. Yerden çöpleri topluyor adam ya. Muhtemelen bahçesinin önü. Ama yine de bunu yapıyor. Ve 17 yaşındaki gençler var bir de. Çöp atıyor. Yere çöp atıyor. Havaya bakar mısınız ya? Harika değil mi? Klasik yağmur sonrası. Muhteşem renkler havada. Bakalım yolda köpeklerden yana şansın bir haber gidecek mi bu sefer? Çoban köpekleri var bir tek onlar sıkıntı. Onun dışındakiler uysal da çoban köpekleri bayağı sıkıntı. Bunlara denk gelmezsem iyi olur. Şurası çok sakat. Şu dönemeci aldım mı tamam. Orada bak 8-10 tane köpek var. O ne ya baksana ya. Az önce köpekleri gösterdiğim yerden bir arabayı otostop çektim. Otostop çektiğim ilk araba aldı beni. Hello brother.
Hello. Selam aleyküm.
Aleyküm selam. You're Boşnak.
Yeah, I am. I'm from here actually.
What's your name?
I'm Hasan.
Hasan.
Yeah.
Thank you, Hasan. Thank you
you're
so
welcome,
much. Because
man, you're welcome.
You saw there were so many dogs.
Yeah, I know.
Otherwise, I normally walk.
A lot of stray dogs, really. Yeah.
Exactly. On one hand, I have stone. Another hand, I have carrot, you know. Especially the ones with the hurt are a bit dangerous.
How do you like it here, man?
I really liked it. I really liked it. This is my last day, so tomorrow I'm going to Montenegro.
Yeah, that's cool.
I can walk, it's okay.
No, afternoon. Nice to meet you, man.
Nice to meet you too. Sağ olsun Hasan buraya kadar bıraktı beni. Geldik evimize.
Vallahi yol çok sakattı ya. Çok sakattı. Ondan yani böyle otostop falan yoksa korktuğumuzdan değildi yani. Şimdi yine bir yol günü. Evden ayrılıyorum. Gerçekten çok keyifliydi. Armin sağ olsun. Burada harika ağırladı. Buralı olduğu için de zaten etrafı da çok güzel anlattı bana. O yüzden yani iyi ki geldim dedim Novi Pazar'a. Çünkü biliyorsunuz belki Bosna'ya direkt geçecektim. İyi ki buraya geldim. Burada bambaşka bir Sırbistan görmüş oldum. Hatta
şimdi gidiyoruz.
We had a great time down there.
Yes, yeah, staying in the nature.
Maybe too lonely here.
But it was fine. Yeah.
Maybe to refresh your mind.
Exactly. It was really good.
Yeah. Otobüs saat 1:30'daymış. Şu an bir 2,5-3 saatim falan var. O zaman kadar çantayı bırakacağım ben Armin'in ofisine. Şu karşıdaki kıraathanelere bakın. Tam böyle bizim stil değil mi? Şimdi buradaki son saatim. Ve Ras Müzesi'ne gireceğiz beraber. Şimdi yine arkadaşlarla buluştuk.
What's up? You're good? How are you today?
High school in Ottoman times.
Let's go in. What's inside?
You have to see this first. This is like passport, like some documents.
From Ottoman Empire. Yes. The building is really nice. Şimdi burada müzenin en güzel kısmına geldik. Eski bir boşnak evini görüyorsunuz. But we need to differentiate again Bosniaks and Bosnians.
Bosniaks,
yes. This is Bosnian.
Bosniak, yes.
Boşnak evi. Yani Bosnalı Müslümanların evi. Geleneksel olarak. Böyle görüyorsunuz. Boşnak erkek ve boşnak kadın kıyafetleri. Burası da Sırp. Geleneksel bir Sırp evi. Görüyorsunuz. Religion changes immediately from here to there. See Christian Orthodox.
Christian Orthodox, yes. You can see it's not very big difference between outfit.
Exactly, not much different. Burada da Sırp kadın ve erkek kostümleri var. Bu gördüğünüzse Çanakkale 1915'ten kalma. Mehmet Silezovic.
This is from Derviş. Ekşibendi order.
Bir odada burada var. Bu da kilim dokumacılığı yapılan böyle bir geleneksel oda. Bundan önceki Novi Sad videomda bu şekilde kilim dokumacılığıyla uğraşan çok modern bir evi tanıtmıştım. Orada hatta dünyada sadece 5 tane örneği bulunan bir yere girmiştik. Petrovaradin Kalesi'nin içindeydi hatırlarsanız. Merdivenlerden çıkan gıcırdama sesi çok iyi değil mi ya? Ya da bana mı öyle geliyor bilmiyorum. İzlaz is exit.
Yes.
Şuradan bir izlaz yapalım o zaman.
So where are we heading now? Last hour.
Last hour is for coffee.
Coffee, yes, yes, coffee. Definitely.
And your place? Called Ghana.
Ghana.
Yes, Ghana. It's from country Ghana.
There are some cafeterias like very traditional. We have the same in Turkey and you know these kind of places the elderly people hang out.
Yes. And this place is just for them.
Exactly, just for
you
them.
You can't see any young people.
Any young people, no.
Sometimes we go in there.
Yes.
Yeah.
We don't have a problem with
nice.
That.
Yeah, sometimes it's nice.
Like to drink chai.
And also having their conversation also.
Yes, exactly.
Şimdi son kez şu yoldan yürüyelim. Bir kahve içeceğiz. Muhtemelen Armin de gelecek oraya. Oradan da artık otobüse doğru geçerim ben.
Selamünaleyküm.
Yes. Okay. Şimdi şu tepede bir yerde bir kafeye gidiyoruz.
It's very old coffee here.
Very old.
Yes. Our fathers and mothers kept here.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
Now we are keeping the tradition.
Tradition, yes. Yeah. Tradition alive.
It's like you in the mosque in the minare.
Yeah. Let's go.
Here, you can see it. You have to be in good form.
Yes. That's why you don't drink coffee every day here. Yeah.
Just a special moment.
Wow, it's really nice.
I told you.
Really nice. Şimdi kahveler geldi. Bu arada burada nereye giderseniz gidin şu şekilde su geliyor. Bunlar çeşme suyu ama burada her şekilde içiliyor. Yani çeşme suyunu her yerde içebiliyorsunuz. Genel olarak Sırbistan'da. You understand some?
Yes.
Yeah, right.
Almost everything. Just a hard problem with talk.
Yeah, I think you have the general idea when I'm talking, right? Yeah.
400 years.
400 years.
No, 200.
200.
No, it's not. 100.
Let's say
100.
100 years ago.
One journalist from Turkey. Uh-huh. I think his name Ahmet. He was a traveler here in Balkans.
Yes.
And he was here in this city, in Ayipazar. And he saw that we have a tradition drinking coffee in the çarşıya.
Yeah.
Old.
Yeah.
And it's almost like today we have that. So we have a tradition in drinking coffee.
I think it's something coming from the Ottoman times.
Yes.
Because the Ottoman ruled places, there is always a big coffee culture.
Yes.
And we cannot drink coffee with a low quality. We prefer not to drink at all.
Where are we heading now?
Travel agency to pack your baggage.
Yeah. What was it called again?
Travel agency.
Echo.
Okay.
Çantaları aldık şimdi. So we are heading for Turkish tea.
Best Turkish tea.
Yolculuğa çıkmadan hemen önce şöyle bir 5-10 dakikalığına buranın en iyi Türk çaycısı varmış. Oraya gideceğiz. Oradan da artık otobüste Podgorica'ya, yani Karadağ'a geçeriz. Şimdi böyle bir yerde ikinci katmış. Girelim bakalım. Birer çay. Birer çay uğruna geç kalacağım. For the sake of one Turkish tea, I will be late.